All right.
Hey guys, we thought we'd mix it up a little bit and do a little bit of martial arts training today. We were just trying to come up with something to show you. And please, before we start, seek out some qualified instruction. This is really just for informational purposes. If you're a kid, get some adults involved. Don't try this stuff with your friends without instruction. Okay. One thing I want to get into real quick is some small circle jiu-jitsu and show you how to do wrist locks mainly, and then we'll show how that applies to knife training, and in the future I'll show you how to use it also against other weapons like a gun. Okay. For right now, I want to show you first is the wrist lock. Okay. Now, the way this works is whenever he throws a punch anywhere he's going to do it, the main thing is to get my body offline so that he's going to miss, it's going to deflect. And as it comes through, I'm gonna deflect it like so, okay? With an open hand. Now, as I deflect, then I'm gonna trap, okay? Now, the reason this is important is, like Jeet Kune Do, you can actually trap, pow, and then game over possibly, okay? But also, you can do what I'm gonna do next, and that is a joint lock, okay? So, as it comes in, I'm just gonna deflect, grab, okay? Now, the way I do this, if you can see, I'm grabbing the meaty part of his hand with my fingers, okay? And then what I'm doing is I'm putting my thumb against the outside of his hand here. And what that does is by pulling on this side while I'm pushing with my thumb, it gives me leverage against his wrist joint, okay? Now, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna twist and I'm gonna pull down all at the same time. And what the twist does is put him in a disadvantaged position. And then when I pull down, it should snap that joint, okay? And it takes very little power to break a wrist joint. It's very weak as compared to your other joints, like your elbows and knees. So anyway, what he's gonna do, he's gonna throw a punch in, I'm gonna snag it, okay? Now, even if you grab like here, let's say you just slip and miss, you'll learn over time to like deflect, grasp, and then slide up to the joint, okay? It's just something that takes practice. And once I got him, I can turn, snap, and he'll have to either go with it to the ground or get his wrist broke. There's really no choice in between. Now, if a guy happens to be super strong, okay, so when he comes in and I grab him and I feel like he's got a lot of tension, like he's a power lifter or whatever, there's options. Number one option, and I always do this, is second hand, put your thumb next to the other thumb, wrap your fingers around like so, and then that way you've got two hands on his one wrist, okay, and you can kind of pull him into your center and drop your weight on him. He has to go. Look, with very little pressure, he has to go to the ground, okay? Now, the other option is you snag him, you sense that. You can actually take this hand and use a knife hand and chop down on the elbow joint to fold him, or you can chop down across the forearm, okay? And that way, as soon as you hit a guy in the forearm, it's gonna make your hand just claw up like this, and it makes it very easy to fold him up, okay? And that's something you have to get to where it's automatic, so you'll get sense, and you just be like, chop, take him down, okay? Generally speaking, I have a lot of good luck with the dual hand, putting my weight behind it, and use all your muscle on it, and take him down. Now, the reason this applies to weapons, and we're gonna use a Sharpie as a weapon, oh, a pen, actually, have Jordan hold this pen. Now, Jordan can actually explain to you the difference in how a guy holds a knife and why it's important. If a guy's holding a knife like so, what is he planning on doing most likely?
Stab for center mass in the chest.
Okay. He's planning on stabbing you when he's holding like this, because just look at it. It's just made for that. He's not going to go like this or anything weird like that. I mean, you never know, but generally speaking. And when a guy stabs you, he's not going to stab you in the shoulder, you know, or over in the side. He's going to try to get you dead center because he wants to make sure he hits, because he knows if he misses, he could die. Okay. So you know what's coming here. So that's an advantage to you, just seeing how he holds it, okay? Now, if a guy flips it around, holds like this, and he's holding like here when he comes in on you, what's he gonna do?
High overhead.
Chances are the guy's gonna come down like so, okay? And Jordan's gonna show you how to deal with that here in a second. Now, first, we're gonna have him hold it. Now, I've noticed when he walks up, and I wanna be defensive, like, hey, I don't want no problem with you, just like I showed you before in my video, okay? Now, but I've noticed he's holding it like this, so I know he's planning on just stabbing me, okay? So when he comes forward with that, I move my center out of the way. That's the main thing. Get your center mass over, okay? Not too exaggerated, just enough to get out of the way, okay? Now watch, so center out of the way, and that way, say I miss my deflection a little bit or can't trap, he still didn't stab me, okay? So when he comes through, move center, grasp, okay? Now I've got him. Quickly, I will actually snap with all my power. Main thing, number one, snap that wrist, no matter what. Bam, snap, okay? Use all that pent up power. Snap. Now, once I've done that, I'm actually going to force him to the ground.
just through the force of my body on that wrist, okay? Once I've got him down there, I'm grasping his hand around the knife. I can actually cut his own throat with it without me ever even touching the knife. And then, you know, game over for him. Or I can actually do it, cut his throat, and then just peel it out because he's done anyway, okay? And I can walk away with the knife. Okay, so that's number one, is when I see that, I notice it's coming here, I'm gonna move my center line, snatch, bring him down, cut the throat, done, game over, okay? Now, I'm gonna let Jordan do a couple here real quick. Now, if I'm holding it like so, okay, it looks like I'm gonna do an overhead stab. There's a couple of methods for doing that. Jordan knows to be ready at all times to do that. So, okay, now, what he's chosen here, just as a reflex, is an X block. And once he gets me in that X block, he's got me pinned in there, you can see. Then he's gonna grasp, and he's gonna twist, and he's gonna hold it up behind me and peel the knife away from my hand, okay? Because behind my back like that, I have no power. Now, the alternate option to that is a different type of block, and he's ready, like that, okay? Now, he's gonna hold his arm at an angle so that if anything, it might slide down if it's too much of an angle. If it's here, he's got an angle. We got a dog coming in, that's okay. But as we come down, he can open hand again so he can trap, and then he can pull it in. He's pinning it, if you can see, against his hip, and he's already made this motion towards my throat. And he's gonna bring that elbow right into my throat, or he can chop, take his hand like so, and just jump, and just chop me in the throat. All the while, never letting go of the knife.
Can I show an alternative one I've seen?
Okay.
Where you go, so like, go like this. You pull it in, and you can step behind their leg.
Yeah, and actually drop
and knock them over.
Okay. And very good. And then always never let go of the knife, correct? Mm-hmm. Okay, because that's most important.
If you take your hand off, they can take it back and stab you with it.
You can pound a guy completely to the ground, and he may appear unconscious. But you never let go of that knife. You, in fact, mostly take it away with you, okay? Because at the very last second, he could come to and jab you, you die. That serious, okay? Never let go of this knife, always. Okay, now.
It's just showing me yours because it's starting to rain.
Okay, starting to rain a little bit, so we're gonna speed this up. The other one is, let's say a guy does a weird outside stabbing motion, I have to step inside, okay? I'm gonna come in here like so, okay? I stepped in, like here. Now, again, same motion, I'm just hitting, trapping, got him, okay? Now from here, I can go pow, I can take him down, but the other one I really like is just step under his arm, and you just bring it up in here, and then just two hands, I can shove it up under his rib cage, right into his liver, just pow, pow, done, okay? So again, outside.
Oh, outside.
Yeah, it's okay. Outside, twist, bring it up, jab, 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 done. Okay? That's just another good one real quick. Now the other thing, I wanna go back real quick to just the wrist locks, okay? Depending on the hand that he's using, left or right, it doesn't really matter, okay? But the rule of thumb I use for myself, and you'll learn this instinctively after a while, is if it's my left hand grabs either one of his arms, then I turn to the left, see, okay? No matter which hand, if I grab my left, I go left, see? I can fold them up this way.
Left is always left, right
left,
is always
right,
right.
Okay? Now, let me show you this one. If you turn him like so, make sure you either put your hand on his elbow, because if I don't, what are you gonna do to me? You're gonna spin, pow, done, okay? Now, so I either wanna pin him that, or I can actually do the opposite and fold him way up here, and I've got him. Look, I can walk him anywhere I want, okay? And, Jordan, if you want to hold on for a second. I'm going to check the time, people, because we don't know where we're at here. Okay, we're at 8:42. We've got about a minute.
Just start.
Okay. Now, there's other variations on these wrist locks. I'm just going to show you very quickly because we're going to wrap it up. Okay? Now, one more stab technique because you can show them real quick. If a guy comes up behind you, okay, and you feel his hand comes over and a knife comes to your throat and he goes, hey, give me your wallet, you know, or you're going to die, what are you going to do?
You grab it with two hands. You step behind him with your foot between theirs, pull it up behind, and then you got it right here and grab like that.
You
so
you
can
jab
it
right up under their ribs. Kidneys, liver, it's all over here. Bam, 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 okay? But the main thing is your two arms against this one, because who cares about this one, okay? Get control of the weapon. Pull it now, game over, all right?
There's a few different ways you can move your feet, by the way.
Now, we'll go into this more in depth in the future. The wrist lock thing, again, real easy. Meaty part of the hand, thumb here, just using the leverage, okay? If we go the other way, we twist, fold it up, no problem. The other variations is, you can actually just straight push the hand against that arm, boom, down like so, and you can actually pin them like this and get the wrist as well, okay? Anyway, we'll do this more in the future.
I'll show you some gun techniques too, how to remove a gun out of somebody's hand, what to do if a guy puts a gun to your head in your car, all sorts of things, okay? So anyway, I hope you like this. We're gonna wrap it up because we're running out of time, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.